Welcome to Let's Play Dark Souls Part 35. As you can see, we are deep in the abyss. This is as abyss-like as it gets. But anyway, we're gonna try to live up to the legend and find the source of this problem. It's pretty cool. Like, it's so dark you can actually see like all the twinkles of items and. Oh wait, those are prism stones. Those are prism stones. My bad. So right up ahead, okay, just the intro. So those are some glowing eyes. There's a prism stone. So I was wondering, it looked almost like a bonfire, but I'm pretty sure there's no bonfires down here. Yeah, we're deep in the darkness. So no time for that. All right. So again, we're gonna try to just aggro them one at a time here and swiftly dispose. And I'm pretty sure. Oh, yep, there is a mage. So let's get our thing ready. Do that. Okay, yeah, see, it becomes a lot, well, a lot harder when you have to work your way into a whole bunch. Or rather, more like when you're surrounded by distractions, it's harder to use the pendant. That's what I'm trying to say. And that. It's actually best used when you are approaching them from a distance, and then they're just raining down death from above. Anyway, so all that trouble got us dark bead. Ooh, yes, that's a cool. It's kind of like a shotgun, but a spell. If I'm remembering this right, that is where you shoot like a bunch of small, tiny dark orbs, essentially in a scatter shot in front of you. But again, we're actually, you know, I probably have the stats to use most of these. Before we check our stats, let's make sure the area is safe. I think we can drop down there. Not totally sure. I'm not gonna risk it just yet. But I do want to quickly check here if this is required. Dark orb. This only requires a little bit of intelligence. So I definitely could showcase some of these things for you guys. Maybe in the next area, because the thing is, it's like Pokemon, right? So. Fire is weak against fire. Water is weak against water. And dark is weak against dark. And yeah, like, do you think dark bead's gonna do a lot of damage against those dark ghosts right there? Definitely. Okay, so that looks like death. I think normally we can walk down here. So we will drop here because I'm pretty sure there's something somewhere you can get. This could just be like a shortcut. Either way, so these are interesting enemies because they kind of just phase through you. And when they're touching you is when they do damage. And I'm sure eventually one of them's gonna get me here. Dance a dangerous dance here. Okay, come on. Ah, yeah, see, there you go. Oh, they do more damage than I thought. So. It can definitely be a problem. I think we know the golden rule at this point, right? When it comes to crowds of enemies. And now these are some of the biggest crowds we've seen yet. I don't know if this is it. There's one area where there's just a lot of these guys. There we go. It is very satisfying though. I mean, you can catch a large group of them. Alright. Oh, yeah. And these are another sort of sad enemy. Because I mean, the whole original problem is that, you know, Ulysses of the town was we're not even gonna. Oh, yeah, okay, that's Dark Bead right there. Right, let's see, fire versus. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, that's the mist. Right, come on. Wow. Just can't hit it. Oh! Well, that works for us, I guess. Now, we will have to make our way up there eventually for that item. But in the meantime. What I was trying to say before is that it's the big ghosts are adults from the town, and I think that means the small ones are their real children. So, very sad, but I'm sure we've seen implied dead children in this game by now. There's the help me carving. We know how carvings work, but that's the one that'll go help me. I think we have to drop down here. Yeah, and then I think yeah, these ones are big, so these might be giants. Could be other soldiers that have been dispatched. Let's see, my phone buzzed a few times, so I'm just gonna quickly put it into Do Not Disturb here. Hopefully the mic didn't pick it up. If it did, that's what those mysterious buzzing sounds were. Ooh, Black Flame. This is a good spell here. That's a Pyromancy. And it's just like Great Combustion, except it does dark damage as well as fire. I don't know, actually, I think it still does fire. I think it's split between fire and dark. Either way, it's very good. It's a really good Pyromancy. And it's part of the Giant Dad build, which I've mentioned on this channel by now. Yeah, the Giant Dad build, you're supposed to have two Black Flames on you. So that means new game plus... And I'll let you finish the sentence. I'm trying to keep this mostly family-friendly-ish, this channel. I mean, not entirely, like, I have definitely cussed, but... I do feel like my mom might be watching, and filter is... always on for that. Alright, so one thing I don't like about this area is there's a few leaps of faith, and I think we can go in that direction because there's an item, but I also don't know. I'm gonna lean towards no because usually there's gonna be some kind of indicator that you can drop down. But I mostly want to. Okay, the main thing, I want to circle back to get that item from the, any of the sorcerers we killed. And I think this is it right here. Okay, cool. And just the humanity. And then she had a green titanite shard on her. Cool. Okay, so I think those are all the important items. Those two spells and the help me carving. So the rest of the items to find are probably going to just be upgrade material or souls items. So let's proceed on ahead then. There actually is another very important thing we still have to do. I think we do that by dropping down somewhere. I may have gone a bit too far, though. Humanity's there. It might be in this cave, but this might also be... Yeah, this is way too far. Okay, so there's the boss, right? That's where we're going to want to go. We still have one more detour we got to make. I think it was back up here. So I came there somewhere. There's the prism stones. I'm just thinking out loud as I do whenever I get lost. I think this here, right? Yeah, so that'll be an illusory ball. And then we land in this mysterious fog. So over there, that's the, I don't know if that is Elvina, but she is like, you know, the Forest Hunter Covenant. And we don't know if that's exactly her, because, you know, cats can all look the same, but this one, at the very least, it's the same model, and it sounds the same, so. There's some sort of link between her and Lucille, so. Let's sort of keep going in the direction that she's leading us here. Getting some men. I don't even know what these things are called. Sprite monsters, something like that. So yeah, she's gonna go right here. And then she's gone, which sort of hints that this is an illusory wall. I'm gonna quickly clean up these guys so that they don't sneak up behind me. Coming through here. Artorias is known as the Wolf Knight, right? And there's a reason for that. It's because he actually has a companion that is a wolf. And that wolf is currently in trouble. So, these guys drop humanity, by the way. This is the best source of humanity in the game, I believe. You just pop on your gold ring and then just clear out the whole abyss of all these guys. But anyway, over there in that golden circle is Artorias's buddy, Sif. These guys will actually cooperate. And I don't blame them for not cooperating since I can't kill them, but if they would, they would let me kill them. And as you can see, they don't get me. There's like a shining ray of gold around them. And he has Artorias's sword in his mouth. And in a second here, once we help him out and finish off these evil demons. And he's going to, aren't you going to, oh, yep, there you go. Sees that we have helped him. He recognizes us, gives us a howl. Off he goes. So what did he leave behind? He left behind the Cleansing Great Shield. And this is the Great Shield that Artorias used before he went hollow. I don't know if he actually went hollow. I think he might have just been possessed by the Abyss. Either way, let's take a look at the shield here. Requires a lot of strength, which we don't have enough for. It's used by Artorias, who succumbed to the Abyss. Deeply scarred by the Abyss, use this to form a barrier to protect his compatriot Sif. Although this drained the shield, its magic defense remains high. So yeah, essentially the story is that once Artorias realized he bit off more than he could chew, he left his shield with Sif to keep him safe. And Sif was sort of just hiding in this cave here. I don't know why the cat didn't help him. You know, like, she knew to find us, but couldn't bother, you know, attack. So I don't know. If you remember the ones that are actually in Darkroot Garden, they can fight pretty hard. So I don't know. My two cents. I think she could have helped a bit more. But if she did, then we wouldn't have been able to save Sif. And now, having saved Sif, we're actually going to be able to summon him for this next fight, which is really cool because I think this is the only summon where it's not a human, like a player model. But anyway, that's gonna be a shortcut that we can activate. But before I do that, let's just quickly peek on what's down here. This goes to where I was before. Oh. Okay, so let's go back up this way. We'll activate up here now, and let's see. Take this way, way up. Let's just sort of give you some perspective on how deep we've gone. Because again, with Dark Souls, everything is to scale. We have made some real travel in the world. And where it put us, it's back here, outside by the your Marvelous Chester and the Artorias fight. And I think we should go have a word with Marvelous Chester, because he invaded us and all. Let's see what he has to say.
Oh, you have quite some nerve, or are you just thick? Fine, then. What is it that you need?
I am dummy thick, my dude. But anyway. Let's see.
Did
actually...
you really slay Knight Artorias? I'd heard the Abyss found him first, but even still, that's absolutely treacherous. Yes, magnificently so.
See, he's kind of a jerk. He's just gonna laugh.
Believe it or not, Ulysseal has brought the Abyss upon itself, fooled by that toothy serpent. They upturned the grave of primeval man and incited his ornery wrath. What could they have been thinking? But to you and I, it's all ancient history. You have to ask yourself, does it really matter?
Okay, so that was actually an important line that until this gave us a lot of context as to what's going on here. Right, so the Abyss didn't just, like, hit Ulysseal for no reason. Ulysseal was digging deep, and like you said, they found the grave of Primeval Man. Now, we'll be confronting Primeval Man in a second here, but first, sort of, there's one more detail to what he said that I want you to pay attention to. He mentioned the toothy serpent told him to do that. I want you to think, do we know any toothy serpents ourselves? We're putting a lot of faith into at the moment. Let you think about that for a second. But let's see what else he has to say.
Well, you've quite the nerve. I've had enough of you.
I think, is that all he's going to say? Yeah, so he's just going to be grumpy, but he's still gonna sell his stuff, which is nice of him, I guess. But nothing I'm interested in, so we're just gonna leave.
I'll be seeing you if you survive your travels.
So I mean, like, I should be slaying him right now, but for invading us and all, but he is a merchant, so I'll keep him around. But anyway, yeah, so Primeval Man, exactly what is that? Well, if you remember way back to the episode one when we watched the opening cutscene, Primeval Man refers to the one who got the Dark Soul, the Furtive Pygmy, right? Because there are four great souls. The Light Soul for Gwyn, the Life Soul for Witch of Izalith, and the Death Soul for Nito. And then that leaves the Dark Soul, you know, the one that the game is called, leaves that to the Furtive Pygmy. So, just grab this right here. We're going to be going down this way afterwards. It'll be sort of like our bonus thing to wrap up. It's in that direction, but for now, let's go back into the Abyss. This is not This is not the way. This is go back up. Yes, we don't want none of that. So let's go back down here. And then I think. Okay, yeah, ours was over that way, I think. Or. Oh, no, it was this one right here. But yeah, Primeval Man. Ulysseal, them being sorcerers, I don't know. We don't know exactly why they were digging. Maybe they were just trying to get some iron, their minerals. Or maybe they were specifically looking for ancient artifacts of dark magic and all that. So they have more sympathy from me if it's the former, but not so much if it's the latter. Because, go knocking on the door of the devil, and he's gonna wake up, and he's gonna ruin your world. yeah, this way. So yeah, all in all, I don't think we've died. It's good. But I'm almost certainly this. Okay, so this boss, right? I've done this whole game in with mid rolling heavy armor. I may have to light roll for this boss because it's gonna be a you'll see. If I can manage to do it on my first try, well, then I'm gonna shamelessly brag. But once I likely die, then you'll see why I might have to light roll. So I think if we go this way, it's a bit of a deep secret detour. Moveset is working out really nice for us here, actually. White Titanite Slab. This is where you can find them. If you need to make two holy weapons, you can do that in one playthrough. But yeah, let's go back up this way, go back down the main path. And if we kill these guys. Just got two more. Three more, rather. Got this little family here. Ah. Okay, no. Yeah, so that's also what's dangerous with these guys, is that you stay locked onto one, and then they go through you, and it completely turns you around. So just be mindful of that. Right here, we're going to find Soul of a Hero, who unfortunately was not able to get the job done. But if we peek down there, actually get a bit of a preview. It's hard to see because it's so dark, but I think this is better. The glowing red eyes there are what we're going to be facing. So without further ado, let's take on the boss. Okay, so this is Manus, Father of the Abyss, and right there is a summon sign. Ow! Yeah, so that's Sif's summon sign, which I'm going to try to work towards. And, oh boy. Yeah, it's one of the unique summon signs, because it's actually in the boss room. Woohoo! Yeah, Manus is a very aggressive boss. Am I already dead? Yeah. So yeah, this is gonna be a fight, guys. Oh wow, they're set at this bonfire last. Interesting. Can I warp back down there? Sanctuary depths, two giants. I don't think I can. Oh wait, actually not. We don't have to warp, because we got the shortcut, remember? What I do have to do though is earn a humanity every time I die now. But it's fine. Like I said, we're gonna be swimming in humanity after this, so no need to be stingy. Although, I mean, the thing is though, we have the ability to grind and get a lot of humanity, but I'm probably not gonna actually do that. So I'm probably still always gonna be short on humanity, which is unfortunate, but it's part of life, right? We're always short on something. If I had enough humanity, I wouldn't have enough of something else. So let's be glad that that's our problem. Anyway, This was the one room where we had to go, yeah. And I don't think I sent the elevator back up, which is annoying, but these are some of the fastest elevators in the game. I do have to give them credit. That Ulysseal magic was good stuff. Still, though, that was like 3 or 4 seconds that I'm not going to get back. So let's be sure to do that this time. Right, just step and jump off. Okay, and I forget exactly where to go. May as well kill these guys. Let's see if I can get some humanity. Right, it's this way, and then up here. Ooh. All right, so if this next one goes as awfully as that last attempt, okay, look, if this goes as awfully as the next attempt, I'm gonna reconfigure my armor for sure. The other tricky bit is summoning Sif, right? Like, I didn't even attempt to fight him, really. I was trying to just get to the summon point. And I think the strategy is gonna be to just fight him like normal and then sort of inch him away from the, can I just drop down here? Okay. But yeah, inch him away from the summon sign, because it's almost like he was actually guarding it, which was very annoying. And I think we also get the cutscene again, which is cool, because most of the time you only get cutscenes once. Yeah, but we're gonna skip it, because you just saw it. Okay. I also think I need to be faster. Okay, come on. Summoning Phantom. Haha! We have to be careful here, because there's this one attack that he does, which is especially dangerous. Alright, we got Sif. Ow. Alright, if Sif can aggro him, that would be great. Okay, I need to heal. Good job, Sif. Good job, Sif. But don't die. Okay, that's the thing. When you see him... Oh god, I might be dead. He like rears back like that. Yeah, he's gonna do this combo, which if you get hit by one of the attacks, you're dead. Not dead, but he will catch you in the whole combo. Anyway, I'm gonna try to focus a little more here. Come on, Sif. Ow. Okay, once he starts doing his magic, is when we're really in trouble. Okay, yeah, his attacks, you can dodge them all, which is nice. Like, right through them, I mean. So once you do get the timing down, you're pretty good. Okay, I am just... Okay, may as well grab the souls. Yeah, that was a good chunk of souls there. Yeah, that one is hard, because he blends into the background, right? It's very difficult to tell where he's actually aiming or what he's doing. I'm saying out a lot here. Whoa. Whew. Hope my hooplas are entertaining for you guys. Ow. Alright, Sif really could be doing more work, in my opinion. Okay, this is when things get dangerous. Yep. Whoa, okay. Come on, Sif. I've got his attention. Ow. Man, I am just burning through Estus. There you go, buddy. See, it's just unhealed, and then I'm immediately hurting again. Yeah, that one I can never dodge. Yeah. Once he spams the magic, you're in trouble. Okay, so I am gonna reconfigure it to a light build here. And see if that'll do me better. I'm a little worried it'll be counterproductive since I've been mid-rolling this whole game. But I'm also gonna kindle this up to 20, which honestly should have just done the first time. But as you can see, we were burning through a lot of Estus there, so... Oh, I need to reverse on first, of course. But yeah, we were burning through a lot of Estus there, and that's not good, so... More is better. Anyway, I'm gonna change my armor. I'm gonna cut to in front of the fog wall, and then I'll quickly show you the build, and then we'll hop back in. So, see you soon. All right, here we are. This is the new build. Nothing too crazy. I used the Mask of the Father to get a little bit more equipment load, and then I just threw on some dark-looking light armor that I had. And yeah, now I can fast roll, just barely. So, we'll see how well this does for us. Very glad that you only have to press that once and not have to hit okay like most summon signs. Just get the souls. Okay. Oh, and you can't cut off his tail, by the way. I just noticed that he had one. Yeah, once you start to get his melee attacks down, it's not too bad, but the trouble comes with his magic for sure. Okay, just dodge and get into counter. Bread and butter, Dark Souls. Okay, oh, back up, back up, back up. Yeah, your best bet is spam back rolls. Now you can get in some good hits after, which is nice. Oh man. Full of that. Oh. Oh, he got me. See what I mean? You get hit by one of those attacks, and that's gonna change you to death. So yeah, cut back to the fog wall. I think there's gonna be a lot of deaths here, guys. Alrighty. What do I always say? Third time's the charm? I believe this is the fourth time, right? I don't know. Oh man. I don't like how this one's going. I can just get safe. Okay, there we go. Get safe, heal. Hit. There we go. I don't know if I've said this by the way, but my advice for healing in a boss fight is only heal when you would attack, right? So you only attack when there's an opening, so it's easy to just get scared and then just heal while like on the defensive. But, yeah. As you know, bosses are not forgiving. And won't let you get away with it. Ooh, okay, good dodge. He always growls after that, so that's a good time to counter hit. Oh, I didn't find it. Oh, wow, okay. Doesn't do as much damage as I thought, but still, that can easily kill. Good job. Wow. Thought Sif had him distracted. Well. Okay, so I'm starting to realize that I'm probably not gonna kill him this episode. That's gonna do it for part 35 here. I'm just making a quick outro here in the middle of my attempts. And I can make the intro for the next episode right after this. And yeah, hopefully we'll get Manus next time, guys. Either way, excuse me, I'm making an outro. Either way, you know the drill. I enjoyed making this. Hope you enjoyed watching. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. So, bye for now.